the championship run.
When you think of this organization and the long-term impact that a change like this can have, and a change for the positive, think of Sting in control.
Yeah.
And think of everything that WCW stands for. Sting is the franchise player of World Championship Wrestling. Sting and Ric Flair have such a long history between the two of them. They go into this Monday night, Nitro Live from Rockford, Illinois, with arguably the most important match between these two ever.
I'll say this about Sting. I'll probably get a memo about it. But Sting has shown loyalty to World Championship Wrestling when almost nobody else in this company can make that claim. You look at Sting's career, he has been WCW through and through for the better part of 15 years. You got to admire a man with that sort of stick-withiness.
Scott Hudson, we are one scorpion away from not having to worry anymore about those wacky memos from the office of the president, Ric Flair. Let's bring sanity back to World Championship Wrestling. I know there are several hundred employees that are going to be in the corner of Sting this Monday as he attempts to wrest control of the WCW organization away from the Nature Boy.
If I get one more David Flair refrigerator magnet, I am absolutely going to bazooka bar from here to the foundry.
Yeah, you heard about Larry this past Thursday, or actually Wednesday on Thunder. Larry Zbyszko with a new nickname, David Deer in the Headlights Flair.
Oh, that's perfect.
Yeah, I heard that went over like a lead balloon in the president's office.
Oh, there'll be another memo.
Yep, there's heat on Larry.
Boy, well, what else is new? Are you kidding me? Lash LeRoux and Kenny Kaos going to tie it up here on TBS. Boy, did you see Lash LeRoux doing an impersonation of Kenny Kaos? I mean, Lash is in good shape, but he can't go muscle for muscle with Kaos.
Yeah, that's a big mistake on the part of Lash LeRoux if he thinks that he can outpower or outmuscle someone the size of Kenny Kaos. He needs to be sneaky. He needs to hit and run and try not to match strength with strength versus Kaos.
I'd like to go ahead and apologize to the closed caption guys for stick-withedness. That's an old South Georgia term, but I'm sure the closed caption guys probably quit when they heard that.
It's all right. The closed caption guy's from Tifton. He understood exactly what you said.
Oh, good. I'll have to find him. Oh, Lash right to the gut on Kenny Kaos. Side headlock from Lash LeRoux. People expect a lot from Lash LeRoux. There are those that say this man has an incredible future in professional wrestling. Oh, maybe not after that. That's a clothesline from Kenny Kaos.
And you know, I'm one of those people. I'm firmly in the corner of the raging Cajun, this youngster from Louisiana, Lash LeRoux. But I think primarily in terms of competing in the cruiserweight division here in WCW, his future is unlimited.
You know, earlier on, we heard from Fit Finley with Gene Okerlund. Thank goodness Fit didn't go out and grab a chair and take out Mean Gene. Mean Gene made it through, but we understand that Jimmy Hart and Lightning Foot Jerry Flynn have corralled Mean Gene backstage, and after this matchup right now, Mean Gene will talk to the leader of the First Family, and you know Gene, he's going to ask the hard-hitting questions, namely, what is going on with the hardcore trophy?
Well, I guess we'll hear the other side of the story, what was behind Jimmy Hart pilfering that hardcore trophy this past Monday on Nitro, and you know, when it comes to the mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart, he only lies when his lips move.
Oh! I didn't know he was an attorney. Kenny Kaos in mid-ring. OH Lash LeRoux and Lash. Do not worry about the fans at ringside. You're fighting Kaos. Oh, look at that. I didn't think Lash LeRoux had his head in the match, but he did. He ducked under that one from Kenny Kaos. LeRoux back up to the apron, ducks again. Show me some veteran thinking in there.
Yeah, but
oh, wait a second.
Don't turn your back on Kenny Kaos, Lash.
Never. The former tag team champion, the boot to the gut. Oh, just a right hand or a left hand leveled him.
Yeah, that was a left, caught him with that southpaw side, and then sent him back first into the safety rail.
That hurt. Did you see that rail move? Those things are like anchored in out there. For Pete's sake. Kaos now. Oh, takes LeRoux into the rail one more time.
Yeah, he just drove the youngster face first into that steel, and now Kaos is going to take him and bring him back into the ring.
Later on tonight, Booker T in action to face Horace Hogan of the NWO Black and White. But right now, the belly-to-belly suplex from Kenny Kaos. Lateral press. Hook to leg. Kaos, two. No. LeRoux out at two.
Nicely done. Nice ring positioning that time by Kaos. Hit the belly-to-belly, or right on the WCW logo. Went for the pinfall follow-up, but LeRoux still had enough left. Still had enough fuel left in the tank that he was able to kick out. Oh, impact into the corner, but LeRoux got the boot up.
He certainly did. LeRoux always thinking, runs in, back elbow, nailed Kaos. LeRoux, the breakdance down, back up. Oh, misses the clothesline. But he wasted too much time.
He calls that the Bourbon Street Blues, but Kaos was ready for it. He's going to take him up with a gut wrench.
Oh, into the powerbomb. Oh, what impact. I can't describe what that sounded like here in the arena. LeRoux. The foot over the lower steel cable to break up the pinfall attempt, but that had authority. That was loud in here.
Almost a last-ditch effort that time by LeRoux as he just scissored the bottom rope to make sure that Johnny Boone, the referee, knew that he was able to get the break.
But LeRoux bites back with a dropkick. Kaos staggered. LeRoux, high risk from the top turnbuckle. Crossbody, nailed it. He hangs on. Lateral press, two. And LeRoux got the two on Kenny Kaos.
Well, it's all about putting moves together. That time he hit the one nice move off the top, but still strength left in Kaos. He was able to avoid that pinfall attempt and kick out, but you notice that LeRoux is quick to follow up his advantage. Uses the boots and now that knee right across the windpipe of Kaos.
Gene Oakland will talk to Jimmy Hart of the First Family following this matchup, but I got a warning. Gene, if you can get word to Jimmy Hart, maybe you want to tell him during the interview, Fit Finley's still in the building. He's going to be in the ring later in this broadcast. Jimmy Hart better not think that because Fit Finley has done his interview segment that Fit Finley jumped in the cab and went back to the hotel. He's still here. Somebody better warn the mouth of the South.
And I know that Finley's very proud of the fact that he came out on top, winning that first ever hardcore invitational last Sunday at Bash at the Beach, and he wants possession of that trophy in the worst way. Scooping a slam by LeRoux, but the much heavier Kaos, and you see that LeRoux pays the price. Pain to the lower back area before he follows up with boots to the side of the head. Reigns in a right hand to Kaos.
LeRoux now taking over on Kaos on TBS. Speaking of taking over, Sting may be taking over come Tuesday morning. I'm going to be at the office Tuesday morning, I'm telling you. I'm going to catch the early flight from Chicago to get back to Atlanta to WCW Central just to see Sting take over that corner office. I've got confidence in the franchise.
You imagine the celebration in Atlanta, Georgia, if that's the case. They'll have balloons, they'll have posters. The WCW employees will be here to welcome Sting as president of World Championship Wrestling if everything goes well on Monday night.
I certainly hope so. Meanwhile, Kenny Kaos, at the clothesline, leveled Lash LeRoux. But LeRoux's back up, ran right into it, shoulder high on Kaos. LeRoux all but out on the shoulder. Oh, big front slam.
Tremendous power slam that time by Kaos, taking LeRoux down to the mat. Going to go out to the ring apron.
LeRoux
loves to slingshot himself up to the top, and that's just what he did. Caught him with the clothesline.
Look at this. Cradles him up. Nicely done, and that will do it. With the springboard clothesline from the top, Kenny Kaos gets the Duke over Lash LeRoux.
Kenny Kaos put together a series of power moves, and that was the key, punctuating things with that clothesline off the top rope to gain the three count.
Standing by backstage to ask the hard questions. Me, Gene, and Jimmy Hart.